This is session two of Why Jesus Came. And yesterday we were looking at the relationship between God and human beings and how that perfect relationship was broken by the disobedience of Adam and Eve. This led them to be banished from the garden and they had to work the soil to provide for their needs. Now we have the story of quite some passing generations who had a limited understanding of God. There are a few who are mentioned as having found favour with God, like Noah. But God actually begins his action of bringing people back into relationship with him in the person of Abram. Now, Abram felt the call to leave where he lived and to go to a land that God would show him. I will make you a great nation and I will bless you. I will make your name great and you will be a blessing. I'll bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all the peoples of the earth will be blessed by you. That's Genesis 12:2. So Abram set out in obedience with his wife Sarah and his nephew Lot, who was the son of a brother who had died. They took all their possessions, their cattle, and the people with them. When they arrived in Canaan, God said to him, "To your offspring I will give this land." So Abram built an altar there, and then he moved east towards the hills, built another altar, and then he set south into sort of the Negev desert area. Now, after some time, Abraham and Lot had to separate because there just wasn't room for both of them and their flocks. And so they went to separate areas. And Lot chose an area that was later attacked by some of the surrounding kings, and Lot himself was captured. When this was reported to Abram, Abram raised an army to defeat those kings and to rescue his nephew. This is the first mention of that family system known as the patriarchal system. It was the duty of the eldest male to look after the rest of the family. Abram taken Lot under his wing when Lot's father died, and now he's fulfilling that duty again by rescuing and restoring Lot. Even though they'd gone their separate ways, Abram still had that duty. He was bound to restore his nephew. This is when we meet Melchizedek. He's named as a priest of the Most High God, and he blesses Abraham. And then Abraham had a vision that God encouraged him and said, "Don't be afraid, I'm your shield." And he received the promise that his descendants would be as numerous as the stars. Now, Abram and Sarah were childless. Both of them were well past childbearing age. And yet, Abram was able to believe the promise. And it says that God credited it to him as righteousness, the fact that he believed a promise. God made a covenant then, said, "To your descendants I give this land from the Wadi of Egypt to the great river Euphrates." And so this was the beginning of God's plan to redeem human beings, that is, to bring them back to him, to restore them, bring them back into right relationship with him. To be righteous is to be in right relationship with God. And when Abram believed God's promise, despite what it looked like in human eyes, that was credited to him as righteous. And it's this combination of his belief and his obedience that is the foundation of the way God is going to rebuild that relationship. In this story, we have the notion of redemption, that is buying back or restoring, redemption of Lot, and then also the foundation of belief and obedience. And God's going to build a nation called Israel on that foundation to carry out his plan.